Today, we're diving into a brand new Squarespace feature that makes navigating your site smoother than ever. It's called anchor links, built-in anchor links for page sections. So no more messing with custom code to do this. It's built right in. So I'm going to show you how it works and give you some pro tips and use cases. All right, let's jump in. So what are anchor links? Click on one of these things in the Squarespace help desk and they jump you to a relevant section of the page. That's an anchor link. So they're perfect for long pages, for tables of contents, quick navigation. So you can use them on a lot of the sections on your site, but not on blogs, events, store sections, or portfolios. But you can easily create a little one row blank section above the section in question that doesn't support anchor links and use that to link to it. So let me show you how to set one up. So this is my bokeh template for videographers. Down here on the homepage, we've got this testimonials section. So let's say I wanted to have a link right in the header navigation that would slide me right to this testimonial section. Well, you go to the section in question, you click edit. Let's add the anchor link testimonials to that. With one click, I can copy that link. And now I can go up to the top. Let me save, get out of edit view. In my main navigation, I could create a link, we'll call it testimonials, paste the full link of the anchor link. And now, if I click that link, it scrolls me right down to that section. Isn't that cool? Okay, so this is a great example. Here's a website I built for a private school. And so they've got a long page about all the different academics, right? There's a lot going on there. So what I've done using anchor links is I've gone down and assigned a section ID and anchor link to each of the major academic sections, see pre-K, kindergarten, and so forth. And I've built a little table of contents right here at the top of the site so that a site visitor who lands on this page can click and jump right down to the page section that they're interested in. This is a fun use of the Squarespace menu block, by the way, that I haven't seen in many other places, which is using it for course descriptions. So a table of contents for a long scrolling page is one great use of anchor links. And you could also do this, by the way, if you wanted in the site navigation. So if instead of just linking to the page at the top, you wanted to have a dropdown, you could create a dropdown. Say we call it academics. And then you add in your anchor link URL for each page. And when they navigate to that link using the navigation, it pulls them right there to that section. You could do the same thing in the footer. A lot of people like to have a lot more links in the footer, and you can do that even if you only have a few long pages by using anchor links to the relevant sections of your long pages in the footer. Linking to the top or bottom of a page. So a lot of websites will have a back to top button, and that's honestly better accomplished using some kind of custom code snippet like this one that Will Myers made. It's great. I'll link to it. But if you just wanted to have a single back to the top button on a single page, you could accomplish that by having the top section of your page have an anchor link like maybe top. And then you could go down anywhere later on your page and add a little back to top button, use that link. That would accomplish the goal of bringing them back to the top. It's not a great solution unless you really only need it on that one page, but it's doable. A more interesting use case that I think is maybe more relevant is if you have a footer section. Say a lot of people will build a footer with multiple sections and maybe the top section will be some kind of transitional call to action. So say this is like a subscribe link, a newsletter. So you can see I've done that here. If you wanted to have subscribe links throughout your site that always jumped people down to that one same subscribe block in your footer, you could make a button that links to the subscribe section in your footer. And because your footer loads on every page of your site, any link on any page that just has #, #subscribe as the URL would slide you right down to that section of your site footer. I think that's a cool use. Another cool use, of course, is if you have like a learn more type transitional call to action on your homepage section that just scrolls them down to like the next view of the page, then you can create an anchor link for the next section of the page and make that your link. So now when they land on the homepage and they want to learn more, they click explore and it should scroll them down. That's a simple trick and a simple use of anchor links. Last but not least, using anchor links to target a section with custom code. So these anchor links become ID attributes. So you can target sections in your custom CSS using just pound or hashtag, whatever the anchor link is, instead of the data section ID thing. It's just super clean and easy to remember. You don't need to go peep in the source code to get the data section ID. Just remember that if you're doing that, you can't use the same anchor link ID twice on the same page. So if you're trying to use that for styling multiple blocks on the same page, you would need to use CSS that targets a particular string in the page ID. Here's Will's post on anchor links for custom code. He's got a couple good snippets in there that are useful. I'm not going to demo the workaround for unsupported sections. Other people have done that. Christy Price. A couple more best practices and limitations. So each slug, like I said, has to be unique on that page. Keeping them short and readable is good because they show in the browser URL if someone clicks on them. If you change your domain or your page slug, you need to update these links. They do not auto update. I've been hoping, wishing for years that Squarespace would introduce a sort of auto redirect feature that when you changed a page URL, they automatically created a redirect. Shopify does that. A bunch of other builders do that. Squarespace has not done it yet. So if you change your domain or page slug, you need to either create a redirect that'll handle these tweaks or update your links. And of course, these don't work on Squarespace 7.0, 7.1 only. So if you're on 7.0, you're going to need to do the good old fashioned way of creating anchor links using custom code blocks. Built-in anchor links in Squarespace, no code needed. It's a simple, powerful feature. I'm glad they finally rolled it out. I've been using code blocks for anchor links for years. If you've got questions, drop them in the comments. Thanks for watching. Happy building.